Good morning. We continue with the aromaticity. Last class we discussed non-benzenoid aromatic compounds. In non-benzenoid aromatic compounds, there is no benzene ring, and instead we can see the first class is non-benzenoid aromatic compound. That means heterocyclic aromatic compounds. Okay, that means in the ring there is a hetero atom. That hetero atom donates, or the unshared pair of electrons present on the hetero atom, like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, etc., will take part in the delocalization, and which will help to maintain the aromaticity of the molecule. Now another class of compounds that is also coming under non-benzenoid aromatic carbon, that are cyclic ions. You can see that cyclic ions can act as non-benzenoid aromatic compounds. Non-benzenoid cyclic ions can act as non-benzenoid aromatic compounds. What do you mean by cyclic ions? Look at here. This is cyclopropane, because all this is cyclopropane. And if suppose here is a double bond, then it is known as cyclopropane. Look at here, whether cyclopropene is aromatic or non-aromatic, cyclopropene. Of course, the first condition, what is that? It must be cyclic. That is, it is cyclic. Of course, the compound is cyclic. Second condition, 4n plus 2 pi electron. 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Look at here. When n equal to 0, what do we get? We get how many pi electrons? 4 into 0 plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, 2 pi, of course, the molecule is having 2 pi electrons, that also it is satisfying, correct? What is the number of pi electrons in the system? Cyclopropene, 2 pi electrons, only 1 pi bond. How many pi electrons? 2 pi electrons. So when n equal to 0, you are getting 2 pi electrons. That second condition is also satisfying. Now look at the third condition. What is that? Complete delocalization, whether it is possible. Suppose the bond, this bond is, if it is shifting to here, there is no alternate double bond and single bond. That means here there is no conjugation. Double bond, single bond, again single bond. That means there is no conjugation. What is not possible? Delocalization is not possible. No conjugation. And of course, if you come to planarity of the molecule, okay, leave that part, because planarity also, not because this is sp3 and here it is sp2, so that part is leave. Okay, anyway, you look at the delocalization of the molecule. The delocalization of the molecule is not possible because the conjugation is not possible. That means if a molecule is satisfying all the four conditions for aromaticity, you can say that that compound is aromatic. If it is not satisfying any of the four conditions, that compound is that molecule is non-aromatic. This is non-aromatic. Even though it is cyclic, then it is satisfying 4n plus 2 pi electron system, but the conjugation is not possible, or the delocalization is not possible. Hence, the molecule is said to be non-aromatic. If a molecule cannot satisfy any of the four conditions of aromaticity, that molecule is non-aromatic. This is the case of cyclopropene. Now, instead of cyclopropene, look at here, this is very important. This is cyclopropene, and of course here is a carbon. In that carbon there are two hydrogen atoms, correct? CH2, here it is CH2, because there are, in this carbon there are two hydrogen atoms. Now by any means, if you remove a hydrogen atom, that means if you are removing a hydrogen atom, the bond breaks from carbon. If you are removing a hydrogen atom from carbon, what we get a structure like this. And of course, since a hydrogen atom is removed from this carbon will get a positive charge, clear? And what is this this ion name? This is known as cyclopropenyl cation. So this is cyclopropene and this is cyclopropenyl cation. Now we can see that cyclopropene is non-aromatic, but the important point, cyclopropenyl, this cation, this is aromatic. This molecule, this ion is aromatic. Okay, why this cyclopropenyl cation is aromatic in nature? Cyclopropene is non-aromatic, right? Cyclopropenyl cation, how it is forming? By any means, we are removing a hydrogen atom from this carbon. Okay, so now this carbon, in cyclopropene is this sp3 hybridized. After removing this cation, they change to sp2 hybridized. Now there is a planarity, and leave that part. And look at it here, cyclopropenyl cation, okay, is aromatic in nature. Why it is aromatic in nature? Look at it here, cyclopropene, the delocalization was not possible, that's why it is not aromatic. But here you can see that, first condition, what is that, cyclic, that condition is satisfied. Second condition, what is that, this is planar, all the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized, planar. Third condition, 4n plus 2 pi electrons, when the number of pi electrons is 2, when n equal to 2, you are getting 4n plus 2 is equal to 2, so that is also satisfying. And the last condition, complete delocalization. How complete delocalization is possible in cyclopropenyl cation? Look at here, due to the formation of a positive charge on this carbon, because this is a pi bond means it's a pair of electrons. Since a positive charge is created on this carbon, what will happen? This bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. So you get a structure like this, but it will become like this. Okay, here it is like this. Since the bond breaks from this carbon is getting a positive charge, and the bond will become like this. Okay, you get the structure like this. Now this bond is like this. This is a pair of electron. Because of positive charge, this pair of electron will be attracted by this positive charge. Therefore, what will happen? The bond breaks from this carbon and it will come like this. Okay, now here it is positive charge. So one resonance. And you can see that one delocalization. In the next step, what will happen? Due to the presence of a positive charge on this carbon, what will happen? This bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. So what we get? You get the resonance structure like this. What is that? Here is double bond, and since the bond breaks from this carbon is getting a positive charge. Correct? And the next step, what will happen? Since a positive charge is created on this carbon, what will happen? This bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. So again, what is it? You are getting the same structure. So that means here you can see that a complete delocalization of pi electrons is possible. Therefore, cyclopropenyl cation is aromatic in nature. But cyclopropene is non-aromatic because delocalization is not possible. And in cyclopropenyl cation, delocalization is possible because of the positive charge present on this carbon. Therefore, this ion, cyclopropenyl cation, is aromatic in nature. Okay, hope it is clear to you. Okay. Now another ion, we are discussing cyclic ion. So cyclic ion, cyclopropenyl cation, is aromatic in nature. Now another one, look at it here. Another example for a cyclic ion, which is a non-benzenoid aromatic compound. Look at it here. This is the compound. What is this one? Actually, there is no double bond. This compound is how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 membered ring system, cyclopentane. Cyclopentane. Now, this is, here is double bond, and here is also double bond. So, this is known as cyclopentadiene. There are two ene, that means two double bond, diene, cyclopentadiene. check whether this compound is aromatic or non-aromatic. So first condition cyclic, second condition 4n plus 2 pi electrons, 4n plus 2 pi electrons, okay. 4n plus 2 pi electrons, okay. What is the number of pi electrons? 2 plus 2, it is 4. What is the number? N equal to the number of pi electron in this system is 4. Now let us check whether it is matching with our formula. First, when n equal to 0, it will become 2, not possible. Now when n equal to 1, it will become 6. So this is not matching with our formula 4n plus 2. So this is non-aromatic. Non-aromatic because 4n plus 2, 4n plus 2 is not matching. Okay, 4n plus 2 pi electron system. When n equal to 2, it will become 2. N equal to 0, it will become 2. When n equal to 1, it will become 6. But our number of pi electrons, 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. That means it is not matching with the 4n plus 2 pi electron rule. Okay, so this compound is non-aromatic. Non-aromatic. But now look at here. Look at here, the same molecule compound. Here, look at here. Here is again. This carbon is having two hydrogen atoms. Two hydrogen atoms. Now, by any means, okay, what we are removing? We are removing H, only H. That means we are removing H plus ion. We are removing a proton. In the previous case, we are removing a hydrogen atom. That means the bond breaks from carbon and it will change into a cation. Here it is not like that. We are removing only the proton. Therefore, what will happen? This pair of electron will go back to carbon, and what ion like this. See, look at here. Okay, here it is like this. Here it is bond, and here it is this carbon is getting a pair of electron and a negative charge. Okay, because we are removing only H plus, and this pair of electron is coming back to carbon. That means carbon is getting a pair of electron and of course a negative charge. This is known as cyclopentadienyl anion. What is this one? Cyclopentadienyl anion. This cyclopentadienyl anion is aromatic in nature. Cyclopentadiene non-aromatic because it is not satisfying 4n plus 2 pi electron system or 4n plus 2 pi rule. But here you can see that cyclopentadienyl anion, after removing a proton from this molecule, this will change into anion. This molecule, this ion is aromatic. This is aromatic. Why this is aromatic? Look at it here. First condition, cyclic condition. Second one, planarity. All the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized in this state. Third condition. So in the cyclopentadiene and the cyclopentadienyl anion, cyclopentadiene is not satisfying 4n plus 2 pi electron system. Of course, it cannot satisfy delocalization, because in cyclopentadiene this two electrons are not there. First condition, what is that? 4n plus 2 pi electron, that condition is not satisfying. Second condition, delocalization of pi electrons. Of course, double bond, single bond, again single bond. That means in cyclopentadiene, what is not possible? Delocalization is also not possible because conjugation is not there. But when you come to cyclopentadienyl anion, we can satisfy all the conditions of aromaticity. Look at here, 4n plus 2. So count the number of pi electrons in this system. 2 plus 2, 4. And of course, you have to count this unshared pair of electrons. This is also 2 electrons. So what is the number of pi electrons? 6. So our rule is 4n plus 2. We can see that when n equal to 1, it will satisfy, it will get 6. So what is the number of pi electron in cyclopentadienyl anion? 6. It is supporting with 4n plus 2 pi electron rule. That condition is satisfied. Now you can see that Next iteration, complete delocalization. Yes, of course it is possible. You look at it here. If this bond is shifted to here, correct? Then what will happen? This bond will be shifted to here, correct? Then what will happen? This pair of electrons will be shifted between these two. So, complete delocalization is possible in cyclopentadienyl anion. That is the difference between cyclopentadiene and cyclopentadienyl anion. Cyclopentadiene, it cannot satisfy 4n plus 2 pi electron rule. And the second one, delocalization is also not possible. The compound is non-aromatic. But here you can see that cyclopentadienyl anion complete delocalization is possible and it can satisfy 4n plus 2 pi electron system because due to the presence of this unshared pair of electrons after the removal of a proton. Okay, so that is the second one. What is that? Cyclopentadienyl anion. Okay, then next one is so this is the second, what is that, a cyclic anion, what is that, a cyclopentadienyl anion. First one is what is that, a cyclopropenyl cation, okay, cyclopropene is non aromatic, cyclopropenyl cation is aromatic. So that is the first cyclic ion, cyclopropenyl cation. Second one is cyclopentadienyl anion, this is also aromatic. Now third one, next ion, cyclic ion, which can show aromaticity. Look at it here, we have a cyclic compound. Okay, here you can see that it is double bond, and single bond. Okay, in this compound, you can see that, look at it here, this is our compound, okay, this is, cycloheptatriene. What is that, this one is cyclo, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, look at here, whether this compound is aromatic or non-aromatic. Okay, look at here, this is cyclic, then let us check the number of pi electrons, 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6. Okay, it is according with 4n plus 2 because when n equal to 1, what we get 6. So it is satisfying 4n plus 2, 4n plus 2 pi electron system, cyclic system, 4n plus 2, that is also satisfied. Next is delocalization of pi electrons. double bond, single bond, again single bond. That means conjugation is not possible, delocalization is not possible because there is no conjugation. Okay, look at here, if double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, again single bond. Also, that means delocalization is not possible in cycloheptatriene. So this molecule is non-aromatic because it cannot satisfy all the conditions of aromaticity. So this is non-aromatic. But look at it here, in from this one, if you remove, okay, look at it here, if you remove, again I am drawing the same molecule. Okay, here it is like this. Okay, here it is double bond, and look at it, here it is carbon, hydrogen and hydrogen. Now, from this compound, from cycloheptatriene, if we are removing a hydrogen atom, not a proton, so the bond is breaking from carbon. Okay, so what do we get after a bond is breaking from this carbon? Look at it here, we get the molecule will change after removing a proton, after removing a hydrogen atom. What do you get? This carbon is getting a positive charge because of the bond breaks from carbon, this carbon is getting a positive charge. This is known as cycloheptatrienyl cation, cycloheptatrienyl trienyl with a positive charge, a cation, trienyl cation, or it is also known as propylene cation. Propylene, very important, propylene. PY, propylene cation. This cycloheptatriene is non-aromatic, but cycloheptatrienyl cation or propylene cation. This is aromatic in nature. This is aromatic in nature. Why this is aromatic in nature? Look at it here. If you can satisfy first, what is the difference between cyclopentatriene and cyclopentatrienyl cation? In cyclopentatriene, what was not possible? The delocalization was not possible. Here, the delocalization is also possible. How the delocalization is possible? Look at it here. You can start from anywhere. Since a positive charge is created on this carbon, because of this positive charge, this pi electron will be attracted towards here. So what will happen? This bond breaks from this carbon and it will come here. Correct? The bond breaks from this carbon and it will come here. So here it will become a double bond. Then what will be created here? Here it will become a positive charge. Now what is in the next step? Because of this positive charge, the bond breaks from this carbon, it will be shifted to here. So here it will become a positive charge. Okay, in the next step what will happen? Since a positive charge is created, this bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. Here it will become a positive charge. When it is creating a positive charge here, what will happen? The double bond formed here, it will be shifted to here, and here it will become a positive charge and it will continue like that. Clear? And that means due to the positive charge created on this carbon, what is possible? The complete delocalization is possible, and therefore this cycloheptatrienyl cation or propylene cation is aromatic in nature. Okay, so if you want, just look at it here. Okay, next step, okay, here it is like this. And since the bond breaks from this carbon, here it will become a double bond. Here is positive charge and here it is, okay, like this. And in the next step, what will happen? This will be, because of positive charge on this carbon, the bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. So what will happen? You get a structure like this. Here it will become double bond and here it is positive charge. In the next stage, what will happen? The bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. That means here it will become double bond and here it will become a positive charge. Okay, and in the next step what will happen? Since a positive charge is created on this carbon, the bond breaks from this carbon and it will be shifted to here. So what will happen? Here it will become a double bond and here it's supposed, and again this will continue like this. Okay, that means a complete delocalization is possible. Therefore, a cycloheptatrienyl cation or a propylene cation is aromatic in nature. So these are non-benzenoid aromatic compounds. First five, what is that? For pyrrole, what is that? Furan, thiophene, and pyridine, that are due to the presence of a hetero atom on the ring. The lone pair or unshared pair of electron present on the hetero atom will involve for the delocalization of pi electrons. Here also you can see that the ions, whether it is sometimes it will be an anion or a cation, because of that ions, what will happen? This compound will become aromatic in nature. Okay, so that's all about this non-benzenoid aromatic compounds. Thank you. We continue in the next class.